Dear children, I welcome you once again to our G-Square Math channel. Hope you may enjoy the previous four or five videos. It completely elaborately discussed about the algebraic expressions. What is algebraic expressions? What are the terms of the algebraic expressions? What are the coefficients? And everything in detail we discussed. At that time itself, when we started the algebraic expression also, we told that polynomial is slightly different. All algebraic expression need not be polynomial, need not be a polynomial. But all polynomials are algebraic expressions. When you are telling this polynomial, this and that, everything, what is polynomial? In the previous chapter also, in algebraic expression, we learn any algebraic expression having more than 4 or 5 terms. We used to call it as a polynomial expressions. So now in slightly elaborate, you are going to study about the polynomials. Now let us see what is a polynomial. Polynomial consists of 2 terms. Polynomials. Poly means many. Nomials mean terms. Poly means many and nominals means terms. A polynomial is an expression, is an algebraic expression which consists of many terms. First condition. Polynomial is an algebraic expression which consists of many terms. The second most important definition of a polynomial says the power of the variable should always be positive integer. For example, 3x square plus 7 root x minus 3. It is an algebraic expression. It's an algebraic expression. This is the first term. This is the second term. This is the third term. Here the power of a variable x. X is called the variable. We are already in the previous videos, we already learned what is a variable, what is constants. Variables, for example, consist of that quantity which always varies. I started with the example also. The cost of the dosa plus a tips. Tips is a variable. That variable generally we used to denote by any alphabets. Algebraic alphabets or numeric, any type of alphabets. In general, we used to consider x, y, z as a variable. And the small a, small b, small c, generally we used to take it as a constant. But it is not necessary that a, b, c should always be taken as a constant. X, y should always be taken as a variable. No, it's not. But practically, we are applying this x, y, z as a variable. And another thing, a, b, c as a small a, b, c as a constants. So, this is an algebraic expression. Let us see, the power of the variable x here is 2. The power of this variable is x. Root x can be written as x power half. So, the power is half. And here, the power of the variable 3 can be written as 3 into x square, x power 0, and the power is 0. Here the power is 2, here power is half, here power is 0. So if carefully observe that, in this second term, the power of the variable is half, which is not an integer, it is a rational number. So, as per our polynomial definition, what we started with, polynomials are algebraic expressions in which the power of the variable should always be a positive integer. It should not be a rational number like this. So, this is not a polynomial. Not a polynomial. It is an algebraic expression. Whereas, this is not a polynomial. Why? Because the power of one term is half. Okay, let's take another example. 3x square plus 7x minus 3. Same thing. Slightly different I have taken, of course. This is also an algebraic expression. It consists of terms 3x square, 7x plus 7x minus 3 are the three terms. This is an algebraic expression. Very well as algebraic expressions. The constants, variables are connected by fundamental operations. Even if you take 3 by x, it is an algebraic expression. 3 by x is an algebraic expression. Not a polynomial. It's an algebraic expression, but not a polynomial. 3 by x is also one of the terms of the algebraic expressions. When 3 by x, if you're considering as a term, that can be written as 3 into x to the power of minus 1. The minus 1 is not positive integer. And hence it is not a polynomial. Okay. So this is an algebraic expression. There are three terms in the algebraic expression. The degree of this is, the power of variable is 1, 2, the power of the variable is 1, the power of the variable is 0. So very well, as per the definition of polynomial, each and every term should be, the variable should have a positive integer powers. And hence it is a polynomial. So let us clearly define. What is a polynomial? Polynomial is an algebraic expression in which the power of the variable is always a positive integer. So we can take many examples. We know x plus y whole square, x plus 1 whole square, a plus b whole square we know, a square plus 2ab plus b square. So x square plus x, 2x. Plus 1, a plus 1, a minus 1, whole square, a square, minus 2a, plus 1, a cube, minus b cube, a minus b, into a square, plus ab, plus b square. Three expressions I have taken. X plus 1 whole square is equal to x square plus 2x plus 1. This is an algebraic expression and this is a polynomial also. But where the degree of each and every term is a positive integer. So this also, instead of the variable x, I have taken a, y because you should not have the misconception that only x should be the variable. A can also be variable. So this is also a variable here. So this is also same thing it is. It is a polynomial. This is a polynomial, this is a polynomial. So, polynomials are those algebraic expressions in which the degree of each and every term should be a positive integer. So, from the definition, it's very clearly we know polynomials are algebraic expressions. But algebraic expressions are not polynomials. Instead of saying not polynomial, I can very clearly say need not be a polynomial. Algebraic expression can be a polynomial. We have seen so many examples. But it need not be, we should not conclude that yes, it is algebraic expression and hence it is a polynomial. No. Polynomial, we are having a special conditions in algebraic expressions. What are those conditions? The degree of each and every term should be a positive integer. That's good. Nice. So in algebraic expression also we have studied about the coefficients, the terms. The same thing we are going to apply here also. And the coefficient is for any term there are factors are there. Numerical factors. And algebraic factors. For example, 7x square. So here there are three terms are there. One is 7, another is x, another is x square. The factors of this is this, the factors of 7 is 7. So on the whole, the factors of 7x square are 7, x and x square. In this three, one is a numerical factor, other two are algebraic factors. Numerical factor, why? Because this is number and three. It's a constant. Whereas this x is again a variable. So this is a factor, this is a factor. So these are the factors. So the coefficient of x square is leaving that x square, what is left out in this? 7 is a coefficient. The coefficient of x square, just remove that, thinking that you are removing x square. What is left out? 7 is left out. In 7x square, minus 7x square, coefficient of x square, just leave this and minus 7 is the coefficient. The coefficient should be taken along with a sign which is in front of the term. That's very, very important. 3x cube minus 7x square plus 8x minus 7. So there are four terms are there. 3x cube is one term. Don't think that 3 is one, 3 and x cube are different term. No, this is only one term. Why? Because they are connected by multiplication sign. Terms should be connected only by plus sign, addition sign. See, x plus y or x minus y. This can be written as x plus of minus y. Therefore, we are telling that x is one term and minus y is another term. Terms are connected by addition sign only it is. Okay. So, 3x cube, term is degree, power is 3, power is x, 2, power is 1, the power is 7 is x power 0. So, that is 1. So, this is the way we are considering this power of the terms also. It is. Let us take what is a zero polynomial. Zero polynomial and zero of a polynomial, that's a two different things. Zero of a polynomial is different, zero of a polynomial is different. What is the zero of a polynomial? That we'll see a little later. What's a zero polynomial? Have a number zero. Number zero is always known as zero polynomial. What is the power of this? You can assign any values. You can write 0x square, or you can write 0x cube, or anything you can write, and 0x power n, or any. So if it is a zero polynomial, the power of the variable with a zero polynomial is infinite. We cannot say. So, and hence, there is no degree of these terms. So, let us come. So, my dear children, two, three terms you have learned already. What is a polynomial? What is the relation between a polynomial and algebraic expressions? All algebraic expressions need not be polynomial. But all polynomials are algebraic expressions. Okay. So, what is the degree of that? Degree of a polynomial. We have studied about this each and every term we discussed. What is the power of the variable? Power of the variable. The highest power of the variable in a particular polynomial is known as a degree of the polynomial. 3x power 4 minus 7x cube. Or x plus 8. There are three terms only. One is 3x power 4. Another is minus 7. Sorry. Term should be considered along with the sign. So 3x square, x power 4 is the first term. Minus 7x is the second term. And plus 8. Is a third term. Now let us see what is the power of this, that is 4. The highest the power of this variable is 4. Here the power of the variable is 1. Here the power of the variable is 0. So 4, 1, 0 is the power of the variables. The highest power among this is 4, and hence the degree of this polynomial is 4. So in this chapter we are discussing about the polynomials of one variable. So that power of this highest power of the variable is defined as the degree of this. Now you may ask one question, sir, if there are two variables are there, but I am telling once again, we are discussing only one variable polynomial. If suppose there are two variables, 7xy plus 8 is also a polynomial. It's also an algebraic expression. And it's also a polynomial. It's a polynomial and hence it's an algebraic expression also. Now the thing is, you may ask, what is the degree of this? The degree of the product term is a sum of the powers. Power is 1, so the degree is 1 plus 1, that is 2. X power 8, Y power 5, is one term is coming. Say for example, 8, this one, and this is coming. So what is the degree of this? So degree is the sum of the powers. Degree of the product term will be the sum of the powers. So degree is 8 plus 5, that is 13. So my dear children, but in this chapter we are studying only about this polynomial of one variable. In case in two variables we will be studying later also, at that time the degree of the variable, the degree of the product term will always be the sum of the powers of the variables. So as we studied in the expressions, if the term is 1, monomial, term is 2, binomial, term is 3, trinomial, and term 3 and 4 is, 4 and 3 is a polynomial expression we study. The same way in polynomial also, if the term is 1, monomial, binomial, trinomial, and polynomial. So my dear children, we discuss various terms in polynomials. Let us conclude this today's topic. If the degree of the polynomial, if it is 1, that is known as a linear polynomial. If the degree is 1, linear. If the degree is 1, is a linear. If the degree is 2, it is quadratic. For example, 3x square minus 7x plus 8. Degree is 2 here and hence it is a quadratic. Here it is 7x plus 3. Degree is 1 and hence it is a linear polynomial. If the degree is 3, it is a cubic polynomial. Degree is 4, biquadratic. X power 4 minus 1 is a biquadratic polynomial. Here the degree is 4. X cube plus 1, it's a cubic polynomial. Degree is 3. And if it is more than 5, more than 4, it is known as a polynomial. Polynomial of degree, what it is there. If it is a 5, we use right. Polynomial of degree 5, polynomial of degree 6, polynomial of degree 7, polynomial of degree 8, polynomial of degree of 9. Like this we use right. By up to 4 we are having the specific name. Linear polynomial, quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial and biquadratic polynomial. And let us conclude this today's topic. And we will go to the zero of the polynomial, not zero polynomial. Zero of the polynomial. And till then, I say goodbye.